While iOS has improved leaps and bounds since its initial release, the platform still isn't perfect. Even in iOS 13, some of the stock apps just aren't as good as some of the third-party alternatives out there. Whereas, some features just don't exist on the OS. However, these shortcomings can easily be addressed by the theory, there's an app for that. And that's exactly what we are going to talk about today. Hey guys, this is Abhijit from Guiding Tech, and let's get right to it, shall we? To kick things off, let's talk about a couple of Google apps that you should get on your new iPhone right away. First, there's Google Maps, which is an absolute no-brainer. I mean, you do get Apple Maps pre-installed on the device, but Google's version is just way ahead. Both in terms of features and accuracy, Google Maps offers much more. Sure, the stock app has come a long way since its inception and is good enough for urban commuters. But once you leave the city, you will definitely face some accuracy issues. On top of that, Google also offers a bunch of great quality of life features like giving users the option to avoid highways, tolls, and ferries, providing real-time traffic information, a handy parking detection to save your spot, and even an automatic daylight color scheme. So I guess that might convince you enough to install the app. Moving on, the next Google app you should install is Google Photos. Now, if you have watched our recent video on all the cool new features in iOS 13, you would already know that Apple has released a bunch of handy new updates for its stock Photos app. But if you're wondering why I'm still recommending Google Photos, well, that's because there's one big reason that differentiates the two. Cloud storage. Apple only gives its users 5 gigs of free iCloud storage to store their memories online, along with all the other things that go in the iCloud backup. And purchasing extra storage will set you back quite a bit. While on the other hand, you get unlimited online storage space with Google Photos, provided you're okay with storing them at 16 megapixel resolution, which I would say is quite decent for most users. And even if you do store your photos at full resolution, you still get 15 gigs of free storage. Quite a bit more than what Apple offers. While we are on the subject of cloud storage, you should also consider downloading either Dropbox or Google Drive for the same reason. With iCloud, you just get 5 gigs of free space, which you will unknowingly fill up in no time with your automatic backups. Whereas Google Drive offers 15 gigs of free space. On top of that, extra storage on Google Drive is much cheaper than what Apple offers, so there's another big reason to switch. However, if you don't like Google Drive for whatever reason, you can also check out Dropbox, which also offers 5 gigabytes of free space, and the additional storage plans are about the same price as Apple. Moving on to the next app, there's Spark, an amazing email client for iOS users which beats the stock mail app by a significant margin. Spark offers a ton of useful features including customizable swipe gestures, email organization, scheduling, along with a bunch of personalization options, making it a far better alternative than the stock mail app. And the best part is that it comes with cross-platform support, so if you have a Windows or Android device, you can use the same app across all platforms without any issues. Since we are on the topic of cross-platform compatibility, 1Password is another app you should get if you're not completely sold on the Apple ecosystem. 1Password is an alternative for Apple's own keychain, which you can use on Windows and Android as well. Keychain lacks cross-platform support, so it's only good for you if you have both a Mac and an iPhone. 1Password, on the other hand, is cross-platform and it comes with a subscription product which you may want to upgrade to if you find it useful. Now let's talk about TunnelBear, an easy-to-use VPN service that you should definitely have on your iPhone simply because it doesn't ship with a VPN feature on its own. Having a VPN on your device is a sort of a necessity these days, and TunnelBear is definitely one of the best free ones out there. The free version comes with 500 megabytes of bandwidth, which is good enough for someone who doesn't use a VPN all that often. But if you're a power user, you will need to get one of the paid plans to make the most of this app. Now, the best part about using TunnelBear over any other VPN is that it has a strict no-logging policy, which means that you'll be able to browse the internet without the fear of your activity being locked by the VPN provider. Next up, we have got WPS Office, a feature-packed free-to-use office suite that's definitely a must-have if you ever work on the go. With the app, you get access to a powerful word processor, spreadsheets, and presentations programs, along with a tool which will help you open and edit PDF files right on your phone. The programs offer 100% compatibility with all the popular office suites out there, and it even includes cross-platform support so that you can take your work anywhere and on any device without worrying about compatibility issues. Now that we have gone through a couple of essential utility apps, let's take a look at some cool media apps that you should have on your iPhone. Here again, Google makes yet another appearance with its amazing image editing app that's called Snapseed. The app is among one of my absolute favorites because of the sheer number of editing tools it offers. And the best part, it's completely free to use. Sure, it may seem a bit intimidating to use it at first with all of its features, but we have got a great selection of tutorials on our website guidingtech.com that will get you up to speed with everything that Snapseed has to offer. Now, in order to edit images, you'll need to click some first. And while the stock camera app on iOS is good and all, it still doesn't offer any manual controls or RAW format support. So for that, you should get Adobe Lightroom CC. Now, if you're wondering why I am recommending another editing app as a camera replacement, you are in for a surprise. Other than the advanced image editing tools it offers, Lightroom also packs in a manual camera with support for raw image capture. The built-in camera works wonders and puts all the camera controls in your hand so that you can get that perfect shot every single time. Do check it out if you want to take your photography skills to the next level. Rounding things off is Infuse 6, a feature-rich media player for your iPhone that just puts the stock iOS media player to shame. The player comes with support for a vast majority of media formats and even allows you to stream media directly from other devices. It also includes AirPlay and Google Car support out of the box, so you can easily stream media to your smart TV. The app has convenient gesture controls, which are a pleasure to use, and I'm sure it'll replace the stock media player on your iPhone in an instant. So that's about it for this video. Do check out these apps right away. As always, you'll find the links in the description. And if you know about other essential apps for a new iPhone user, do let them know in the comments below. A lot of new iPhone users will certainly appreciate your inputs. Well, this is Abhijit signing off, and I'll see you guys in the next video.